When Danny came to talk about this idea to make a sequel with the movie that he made with 28 Days Later, I was completely scared. Why me? I'm not Londoner, I'm not English, I don't know the city. But they were looking for somebody who introduced, a kind of fresh vision in the concept, a new step. I've been here for a couple of weeks as a tourist, but never, with this kind of professional and working purpose. So that's why 4 months before the shooting, I came here and I stayed here for a while, trying to know the city a little bit better. But thankful I had a very good crew and a very good art location department, and they helped me a lot. To find the right places, the honest way to approach, this to have an approach with the city was to play a kind of game, mental game, about putting myself in a kind of journalist, and that's why at the end I decided to shoot the movie in this kind of documentary style. Especially the idea about the family, to track this family in this new process in London. And all, and especially the main conflict in the family, which is the loss of the mother. That was something that really, really attached and to me, and I that was probably one of the most important things to develop, because in a way that family, the idea about the family contains a kind of connection with the big story about the infection, the virus in the blood. And you can't run away from your blood in terms of you have the same blood than your family, which is a kind of strange connection with the story. Try to make, as I told you before, a real movie, and sometimes reality means brutality. And I think in that way, my intention was to give to the audience a real horror conception, which is sometimes is very tough, but I think it's the best way to show and to tell the story in this kind of apocalyptic landscape. So I think you need to do it in spite of the fact that sometimes it's, yeah, as I told you, it's so tough. I think there is a combination in the movie with brutal sequences and a kind of strange and weird sense of humor as well. So I think yes, you need to give both things to the audience. To be honest, I didn't make that ending with the idea to make a third part. It, obviously, it has a kind of delivery for a third part, but to be honest, I did it because I believe that ending is the most it's the better one for to tell the story about a kind of curse, the family curse. And this world is absolutely under, in this world, everybody lost the control, and it's a kind of tragedy. And if you want to play this apocalyptic vision, I think the movie demanded that kind of ending.